So we started this week out with asking the question, who are we really? And I hope that the study this week has shown you who you are in Christ Jesus. Our identity is found in Him. If you're a born-again believer, if you're still living your life looking at yourself and thinking, oh, well, I'm a pastor of a church, or I'm a construction worker, or a bull rider, or whatever it is, that's not who you are. You find your identity in Him. I am more than a conqueror. I'm a world overcomer. I'm heir to the throne of God, joint heirs with Jesus Christ. I'm the very fragrance of Christ to God. I've been created in His likeness and image. I've been conformed in the image of Christ. I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. All these things, we find our identity in Him, who we really are. Well, it begins by knowing where you're from. In other words, we looked at Philippians chapter 3, verse 20, and found out that we're not of this world. We're of the kingdom of heaven. We're citizens of the kingdom of heaven. That took place once you're born again. Now again, if you're not born again, that's a whole different ballgame. But if you're a born-again child of God, you are no longer citizens of this earth, but you're citizens of heaven. And with that come certain rights and privileges. We also found out in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20, that we are ambassadors of the kingdom of God. We found out that we are ministers of reconciliation, and representatives of that as far as the kingdom of God goes. We found out that Jesus' purpose was to come to preach that the kingdom of God is at hand. That's in Luke chapter 4, verse 43. That He said, for this purpose I have come. Well, if it's His purpose, isn't it our purpose also? Yes. Why? Because again, we've put on Christ. We're ambassadors of Christ. We're ambassadors of the kingdom of God. That's who we are. Who are we? That's who we are. Amen. And then also we found out that the kingdom of God is not taken with observation. You can't see, the non-believer stands outside and says, oh, I'm a Christian, or I live in a Christian nation. He doesn't understand. Christianity and the kingdom of God has to be engaged. You have to be an activist. You have to get engaged. You have to be involved in it. Just like in the cutting horse world, you can't just come and sit outside and watch and call yourself a cutter. No, you have to eventually invest in a horse and all the things that go along with it, and go in the arena on horseback, drop your hand in front of a judge and be judged. It's the same thing in the kingdom of God. We have to be actively involved. And then we talked about the fact that we become, when we are kingdom people, we are people of power. Why? Because the kingdom does not come with word, but with power. Hallelujah. And when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you are endued with power. Amen. And so if you want to be a power person, you're a kingdom person. Amen. And then also, though, even though we are people of power, we found out that the kingdom of God suffers violence. Comes from Matthew chapter 11, verse 11 and 12. That the kingdom of God suffers violence, but the violent take it by force. You have to be aggressive about this. We have an adversary, the devil, who comes to try and still kill and destroy. It's up to you and I to say, no, it is not taking place. We put on the full armor of God, and we take up the weaponry, which is not carnal, but mighty in God, for pulling down of strongholds and every high thing that exalts itself above the knowledge of Christ, taking every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. See, those are all scriptures that you and I, as kingdom children, need to know. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Amen. Okay, and then finally yesterday we found out that this kingdom of God, the way we really understand it is through a relationship with the Holy Spirit. The kingdom of God is not something you observe here or something you live here. The kingdom of God is on the inside of you, and the kingdom of God comes from a relationship with the Holy Spirit. Why? Because the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Boy, I'll tell you, I hope you'll go back and look at these videos, study them over and over, because that's who you really are in Christ Jesus. Well, today's Saturday. Tomorrow is Sunday. Please go to church. And I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you. You diligently seek Him and serve Him.